that beer.
What does it mean to be Florida man? Well, there's no one standard. You can be anything. Like, just
Florida
a little
man.
Bit above and beyond.
Next
you know,
level.
Like the mullet, the crazy
Next
hair.
Level.
I sleep in a hammock every night. I don't sleep in a bed. Whether I'm camping or I'm at home, I'm in a hammock. So I live this life. I got, you know, my hair. And I got the mullet. I got a mullet under a mullet.
They look ready. Oh, who told you he was going to win?
Which dude? The one on the right?
The one on the left.
One of my nicknames I get with my kayak groups and people I hang out with is Next Level, NXT, LVL. So when we saw that there was a Florida Man Games, it fit right in. I was like, I had to do it. I'm like, I can do this.
He didn't just start with his
competition.
This is a lifestyle.
That's been the world. Okay.
There we go.
3-1. Oh, yeah. Going for Under Armour. Make some noise.
This is the first.
You guys give it up for American Gladiators guest judges.
Hands on your hearts. Lane Pittman's going to do us the honors of the national anthem this morning.
Yeah,
eat that butt.
Do you see?
Yep. Eat that butt! Eat that butt!
I was like, wait a minute. I know the mic didn't make it, for sure.
I was afraid a couple of people were going to get on the trailer.
I have no idea.
He did the, all right. 3, 2, 1, sumo!
I honestly question your Floridianness, to be honest with you. So I've lived in Florida my entire life. I've had the privilege, I guess you would call it, to know a couple of definitely Florida man worthy people. And I wanted to do an event where you could live a day in the life of a Florida man without going to jail for it. So this is it, the Florida Man Games.
Okay, now I never ran from the cops, but they did take me downtown and call my parents, you know?
Oh, if you don't mind putting your pens on the tables, that'll be cool.
Come on, give me something. N43? Oh, wait, bullshit. For real? You win again?
Florida man or woman?
Yeah.
I can't comment on the women because I've only seen all the Florida men out here competing. Next year, we're hoping to see the women out here, 100%.
We've made a big push with promoter Pete Melfi that if you have Florida man, and I know it's iconic, I know it's a meme, and I know there's articles every day, but we need a Florida woman competition. Because the one thing about the American Gladiators that they were revolutionary is that the women, for the first time in sports events, did the same thing as the men.
Exact same thing.
We'd like to keep that tradition here next for the Florida Man and Women Games.
There you go.
Yeah, it has an alligator on it. It's like, there's different aesthetics, right? But I really like the swamp feel. It's my favorite.
Yeah.
I like it.
Why
do you know what I was talking about?
Oh, you don't want to see my legs?
I'm bruised. That's why I'm wearing
it.
I enjoyed the joust.
Yeah, the wet noodle duel is what they called it. But it was really the joust in a pool of mud.
Which was awesome.
And anytime you go, you know, mano a mano, even though it's a Florida Man Games and it's fun and it's supposed to be light spirit, as soon as they said, like, go, these men, they went, right? They went all out.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Do you have any strategy?
Storm surge. How you feeling here on this
What's
one? We're going to take the victory.
Hit him in the balls first. When he goes down and look at what he did, when you fucking look at it.
So I wanted to create an event that people could laugh at all day long, and we know how funny these Florida Man stories are. And so this seemed like the perfect mix of laughter and athletic competition. If you can design athletic competitions around these wild, weird Florida Man stories, I guarantee you people are gonna have a great time. And that was kind of my thought process. And here we are, we got a huge crowd out here hanging out with us on Francis Field for the very first Florida Man games. It's pretty cool.
There you go, hold him right there. And hold her right there, there you go. Give her a great big round of applause, guys. Now guys, you're gonna notice something on the gator. You're not gonna notice in other alligators. He's got tape on his mouth. Why does he have tape on his mouth? No, that's not the reason. The reason is not so he won't bite you. The reason is humans are weird about how many alligators. There's about 1.8 million alligators in Florida. That is one alligator per every 11 of us that live in this state. That's a lot of gators. Fortunately, if you ever come across a wild alligator, what does it do? Nothing. Fortunately, they either run away or they sink, which is not bad, because we love gators. We just want to see them over there.
We will get each contestant on the stage one by one.